Can you see my screen?
Yes,
okay, well,
we can.
Thank you. I'm Roberto Moreno Ortega. I'm a postdoc researcher based at the University of Edinburgh. And I'm going to present a micromagnetic study of the different features that that the forks of non-interacting assembles of magnetite nanoparticles can show. Forks or first order reversal curves are very important because it's a strategy to discriminate, it's a strategy to characterize magnetic materials, and specifically in the paleomagnetic community, it is used to determine the domain state of the magnetic crystal presented in natural samples. So the domain state of those natural crystals is very important for the quality of a paleomagnetic criteria. So this is a key thing to go from fork to domain states. But it could result a little bit tricky to go from a fork measurement to the real knowledge of domain states. I mean, I've seen a lot of forks you saw yesterday saying that this is portes, this is not. But who knows? I just took some random example from the literature, and it looks like impossible to know for which are the domain states from these forks. So, as Evan and Nicolas and saw in his previous talk, you know, a natural sample could be very complex, and that could be the reason of being so hard to understand or to know the really domain state of the particle, because it could be a mix, it could be a lot of things. And the aim of this work is try to aid the forks to try to improve forks to determine domain states by using micromagnetic simulations. Because using micromagnetic simulations, we can simulate separately each one of the components a natural sample can have, with the different sizes it has, the different elongation it has, the different materials, also the different orientation it presents on the natural sample. And we can create a huge database in which we can pick any of the four we have simulated and take it like a brick and construct the wall we want and compare with experiment. So we can really compare forks numerically and experimental. And this is one of the aims of this work. So in this work, we have done a simulation for particle size from 40 to 200 nanometers diameter with 10 nanometer step. We cover a huge range of elongation. And also we included oblate particles because we base a little bit on Evan's work, that he observes oblate particles of this sample. And we only consider magnetite for the moment, but we also consider all the possible field orientations or particle orientation in the natural sample it could have. So from this database, we can start constructing different non-interacting assembles. And I'm gonna show you some samples. These are single domains with and without elongation. And you see that clearly we have a maximum for the non-elongated particle that increase in the coercive axis as we increase the elongation. Also, we can see a very nice feature here. When we increase elongation, we see a minimum going to the left of the maximum here that we cannot see in the 500 elongation because this below is outside the plot. Another example is basically the same, but for a single vortex assemble. This time the particle is 200 nanometers diameter. And for the non-elongated case, well, we see a ridge in the middle, in the HU axis, but we also see noise coming from the top, that this noise is a noisy tail coming from the vortex formation that you can see here a little bit. And as we increase the elongation, that signal start to disappear. I start to behave a little bit more like we've seen before in the single domain particle. And another example is the transition from single domain to single vortex particles. here is the non-elongated particle where the single domain and single vortex state coexist. And as we start increasing the elongation, we recover again the single domain. And to finish, well, we saw like a bigger example in which we mix a little bit of everything. And this is the four diagram we saw that, well, could look similar to some of the four that are published already. And this is the end of this work. So we have calculated a vast set of force for different geometries and field direction that may serve as an input for training machine learning algorithms to determine the particle size distribution, consequently the domain states. So yeah, one of the future targets is to use all the information we generated to train an algorithm that does or extracts the particle size, the domain state directly from a natural measurement, and we don't need to think if it is a vortex or not. This is all I need to say, or all I say in this talk. Thank you for your attention. I know it's a little bit short, but it's basically the end of this work, and I hope you are interested on it. So thank you so much for your attention. And that's all.
Great, thank you very much. If anyone has any questions, you can go ahead. Yeah, Richard.
Hey, thanks. Can you just go back to the 200 nanometer ones? Yeah, okay. So yeah, so you do see quite a strong negative signal just underneath the ridge.
This one, you mean?
Yeah.
I know. It's the end of this maximum.
Okay. Yeah, that's good, because that's often taken as a fingerprint of vortex states. Yeah. See that, and is it always asymmetrical like that? Because you can get a negative signal above it as well, but it always seems to be stronger underneath, as you find there.
Yeah. Well, this is in this case. I mean, there are. Well, we've done a thousand of simulations, you know, Richard, and there are different types of minimum, as I was discussing with Adrian the other day. For example, this minimum that appears here on the left in the very elongated particle, it appears just due to elongation. It is published.
Yeah, that's the there's no way fast. Yeah.
But this one is very different. This one, if you see, it comes from a maximum, follows the noise, and it ends on a minimum.
So, can you actually see that maximum? Is that cut off?
I can just cut off to plot it, but yes, of course, yes.
So there is a distinct positive signal at the top there, and is there a similar one underneath that we can't see? Or
yeah, well, it starts here, but there are two. Yeah.
Okay. Right. Thank you.